रहीम अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे इट इज ट्यूसडे 1 सितंबर 2020 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर लेसन अबाउट इकोनॉमीज ऑफ स्केल इन द लॉन्ग रन। इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट लॉन्ग रन प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन एंड हाउ अ फर्म वाज एबल टू मिनिमाइज इट्स कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन इन द लॉन्ग रन। नाउ I'm going to start a new thing for you people, economies of scale. Last time we studied that returns to scale, that was about if inputs are changed by the firm, how output will be changing in proportion to the change in inputs. That was giving us different types of returns to scale, like constant returns to scale, increasing returns to scale, and decreasing returns to scale. So all these were studied in our last lesson. Now I'm going into detail of the economies of scale. I told you about when long run average cost of production is decreasing due to the decisions of the firms. So it is enjoying what? Economies of scale. Now what types of economies of scale can be enjoyed by a firm? And how to achieve a long run average cost of production in the long run? First of all, economies of scale means what? When a firm is deciding to become larger in size, firm wants to grow in size, what happens? There can be two types of firm's growth, or there can be different types of firm's growth, or size of the firm can be grown by different ways. One thing by its own internal decision, like it is taking an internal decision to become larger in size. Okay. Another is about external decisions. There can be the external factors which are making possible for the firm to decrease its per unit cost. Or there can be the external growth of the firm, like by integration, by merging with other firms, or by international growth of the firm to the other countries, or to become a multinational company. The growth matters what type of growth will take place into the firm. So first of all, I talk about internal economies of scale. Like if a firm is taking a decision to become larger in size, and due to its internal decisions, it is able to reduce its long run average cost of production over the period of time, then we say the firm is enjoying internal economies of scale. Economies of scale is what? When long run average cost of production is going to fall, that is called the firm is enjoying the economies of scale. Now there can be two types of economies of scale. One is called internal economies of scale, and second is called what? External economies of scale. Internal means when firm is taking its decision to become larger in size, so it increases capital, it increases managerial skills or finance into the firm, it is increasing the technology, or it is increasing marketing advertisement. Okay, so by that way, its sales of the product that will be increasing more than increasing cost of advertising. So in all these cases, we can say the firm is enjoying the internal economies of scale, like market. First is called technical economies of scale. Technical economies of scale is what? When firm is introducing a new technology into the production process, and because of the introduction of new technology, if it is able to reduce its per unit cost of production in the long run, then we say this is called technical economies of scale. Another is called a larger firm can easily raise finance for its business. Like a larger firm can issue the shares, it can borrow money from the banks at a lower rate of interest because its size of the firm is showing its stability. So when firm is able to raise finance or capital at a lowest rate of interest, then we say it is enjoying a financial economies of scale. What about the managerial economies of scale? A smaller firm is usually having a single manager to manage all the activities performed by a firm. But a larger firm is adopting managerial skills by different managers. So a business hierarchy will be making it possible to employ different managers for different tasks. Like production manager is separated from marketing manager, finance manager is somewhere else, and purchasing manager, all these managers are given their own tasks. Their job descriptions are defined by the firm. So in that case, the firm will be able to reduce its per unit cost of production in the long run. So different managerial skills will make it possible to manage the business activities of the firm, and which will lead into the reduction in the per unit cost of production of the firm in the long run, and firm is enjoying again internal economies of scale. Marketing economies of scale means what? When firm is advertising the product, nowadays it is an era of digital marketing in which the firms are advertising their products on internet, on social media, in order to attract more and more customers, and ultimately the conversion of the products that will be made possible. Conversion means the sales will be proceeding further. The sales of the businesses, they will be generated through advertisement on electronic media, on social media, and wherever the goods can be displayed by using marketing skills. So marketing team is given a target to increase the sales, how to generate revenue for the firm. So whatever the cost is incurred by that marketing of the product, if sales are increased proportionately greater than the increasing cost of marketing, then definitely it will reduce the per unit cost of production of the firm, and firm will be enjoying internal economies of scale. What are the further economies of scale? We can say purchasing economies of scale. What do we mean by purchasing economies of scale? Do you know, when firms are buying the raw material, they are buying in bulk. They are buying in huge quantity. So if they are buying in huge quantity, what happens? They will be able to buy at lower prices from the raw material supply. So the larger firms, they have enough finance to buy the raw material in huge quantities. And as a result, they will be provided further discounts on buying those raw materials. So this purchasing of the raw materials at the lowest prices by the firm, that will make them able to reduce their per unit cost in the long run. That is called purchasing economies of scale. Now on the sixth point, we can say the risk bearing economies of scale. What is this? Risk bearing economies of scale. What do we mean by this? Actually, when firms are specializing, they are producing a single range of product. And in case of specialization, what happens? If the demand of their product falls, then the whole business empire will be falling because they haven't diversified. So risk-bearing economies of scale means the firm is diversifying. What do you mean by diversification? Now it is producing a long range of products. What are those products? They are produced by a firm. If you take an example of Unilever, it is producing more than 70 different types of products. A single firm is producing the consumer items, which is ranging from first product to the 70th products. So we say there can be 70 different types of products which are produced by a single firm. Do you know, all these products produced by Unilever may not be earning enough profit to remain in business. Sometimes one range of product is making a loss, but Unilever is not going to stop its production because it does not allow any new firm to enter into the market. So what happens? It is covering its loss. Its loss in the form of risk that can be covered from those profitable products where sales are very high. Consumers are demanding those goods. Suppose Unilever is producing Lipton tea and Supreme tea. Both are the brands of a single seller. But Supreme is not generating too much profit for the Unilever. So its loss is converted into the profits of the other profit generating products like Lipton and other brands of Unilever. They are able to cover the loss which is generated by Supreme product. So we can say Supreme tea was having a risk of loss, but Unilever is not closing it down because it will make a room for the new entrants into the market. And they don't want to allow any new firm to enter. So as a result, the larger firm is continuing with the loss-bearing product. So it has diversified. So whenever a firm is diversifying, it is covering a loss of one product from the other product. I can give you another example. Like if you visit Gourmet Bakery, Gourmet is producing a long range of bakery products. So what happens? They have introduced that the bread price of Gourmet, that is about 55 rupees or 60 rupees, although it is not covering its cost of production, but still they are selling a bread at price of rupees 60. What happens? Whenever a customer visits the bakery, he is not buying only the bread. The loss of bread is shifted on different products available in the bakery. That is called a loss leadership. You introduce a product which is bearing a loss, but its loss is covered by the sales of the other products which are also available in that bakery. So only the larger firms, they can bear the risk of loss because they have diversified in their production. Therefore, their loss can be borne by the different product range. Now, the last internal economy of scale will be about welfare economies of scale. Economies of scale. What do you mean by welfare? If you look around, you see some of the firms, they are not only earning profit out of their business ventures, they are also spending money on the welfare of the society as well. Like if some firms, they are saying that they are financing the educational expenditures of orphan students in the society. They are running a school in which they have admitted many of the orphan children. So how to finance their educational expenditures? They can be financed through the sales of their products. So they encourage the people to buy their products because out of their profit, they will be spending on the welfare of orphan people or special children in the society. So people will have a good image of that firm in their eyes because this firm is spending on the welfare of the society members. So as a result, the welfare economies of scale is that which is motivating the people to buy the product of the firm, which is spending its part of profit or part of revenues on the welfare of the society. Suppose a firm says they have to provide a visiting park area to the society. It will be only possible if you people, the society members, are going to increase the sales of this firm. So out of those sales, the larger firms, they will be sharing their profits with the welfare of the society. So it gives a good image of the product or the entrepreneur in the eyes of the customers, then they are motivated to buy more of the products which are produced by these firms. So anyhow, by anyways, if we say this is what the quantity, this is long run average cost of production. What happens? This is a short run average total cost, and this is the marginal cost of production. Previously, firm was producing this quantity in the short run in year one, and its cost of production was very high. So when it adopted technical economies of scale or financial economies of scale or managerial, any of these economies of scale or enjoy, what happens? Its next year average total cost will be shifting downward. This is year one, this is year two. Now, due to new technology, its production has also increased and its long run average cost is also decreasing. In the next year, again, it is changing the size of its plant, and now they are going to have a further lower point of average total cost to decrease and more output is produced. If we join these minimum points of different time periods, what happens? We will be getting this long run average cost of production like this. This is long run average cost. Okay. Can I say when long run average cost is moving along its curve due to increase in production, and back end phenomena is that in every time period, its short run average cost is shifting down. So its long run average cost is declining. Therefore, a downward movement of the long run average cost of production shows what? Internal economies of scale. What are those? They are said to be the internal economies of scale which are enjoyed by any of these reasons due to new technology, due to financial economies of scale, managerial management techniques, they are able to reduce their per unit cost of production, or marketing of the products on social media, on electronic media, on print media, on billboards, they will increase the sales, and purchasing means to buy the raw material at very, very lower prices. And risk winning, when firms have diversified, they are able to produce a long range of products, so their risk of loss will be divided. And welfare economies of scales means what? When the firms, they are spending on the welfare of the society, or they are not polluting the environment, they are producing environment friendly products. So definitely people will be buying those products of the firms which are environment friendly. So as a result, when long run average cost is moving down, the movement along the long run average cost of production is called internal economies of scale. So the minimum point of this long run average cost of production is called minimum efficient scale of production, as I told you in my last lesson. So this is the long run average cost of production's minimum point. This is called dynamic efficiency point. Keep it in mind, we studied the same thing in our chapter number 6 lesson. Then we talked about dynamic efficiency. It will take place in the long run when firm is able to produce its products on the minimum point of its long run average cost of production. So that point is called minimum efficient scale of production. After this, what happens? Long run average cost of production starts rising. If a further produces output, so its long run average cost of production start to increase. What are the reasons behind why this long run average cost of production is start to rise? The reason is the firm will be facing managerial diseconomies of scale. The larger firms are difficult to be managed because of a larger span of control and larger chain of command, the business hierarchy. That will make it possible that long run average cost of production start to increase. So managerial diseconomies of scale will be faced by the firm whenever its long run average costs start to rise. This is called what? Different types of economies of scale, and usually we have managerial diseconomies of scale which will be causing the long run average cost of production to increase. So keep it in mind, when average cost of production is lower, it will make our goods more competitive, not only in the domestic market, but also in international market. That will increase our domestic trade and international trade in international arena. So this is about the internal economies of scale. If we talk about external economies of scale, okay, one thing I want to say, the long run average cost curve is an envelope of the short run average cost curve's minimum points. So it is an envelope. Otherwise, long run average cost does not exist like we are having the short run cost. That can only be achieved if we join the minimum points of the short run average cost of productions. Now, what do we mean by external economies of scale? External economies of scale. It means when a firm is able to decrease its long run average cost, not because of its internal decisions, but it is because of the external factors out of that firm's factor. Like government has improved its hard infrastructure, the road network has been improved, or your neighboring firm has introduced a new technology and they have trained the labor force in the area. Now the new firm will be hiring those trained workers rather to spend on the training of the workers. They have been able to save their training cost. Our government has provided many other benefits to the firms, like in the form of subsidies or reduction in taxes. So we say the external factors, or we can say the health conditions of workers, when they are in a good condition, government has improved the educational institutions or health institutions in order to provide more healthy labor force to the firms, or government has started a new technical college in the industrial area where more trained workers, more educated workers will be available to the domestic industry. Our government has been able to produce electricity at a lowest possible cost of production. When electricity cost has decreased, so overall per unit cost of production for the firms will be shifting downward. So it takes place when long run average cost curve shifts downward. What happens? Due to external reasons, the long run average cost of production will be shifting downward. So this shift of the long run average cost curve downward is called external economies of scale. Keep it in mind, there can be the economies of scope, like larger firm is using a technology for the production of one good, but the same technology could be used for the production of another good. So that technology is having economies of scope. Again, for the next product, your average cost will be shifting downward. So economies of scope are something else, whereas economies of scale are saying either they are internal or external. So external, what is the difference between internal and external economies of scale? Internal economies of scale are showing us the downward movement along the long run average cost of production, whereas external economies of scale are showing us the downward shift of the long run average cost of production, because it is not due to the internal decisions of the firm. They are external in nature. Like government has provided us some of the facilities in order to reduce the per unit cost of production, or labor training cost has gone down, or something else which is benefiting the firm as an external factor that will reduce the average cost of production. It will lower down the average cost of production than firm is enjoying external economies of scale. So I think you have understood different types of economies of scale, both in internal and external. So this is about our economies of scale. Either they are internal, you can study out many of the things which are related to external economies of scale. They can be different for different types of businesses. All right. So external factors can be different, but internal factors, they are almost same for the different firms. If they could be adopted in different time periods, they will be able to reduce their per unit cost of production due to the internal decisions, but external factors will be lowering the average cost of production in the form of downward shift of the long run average cost. So that's all about for today. We have studied in detail different economies of scale, internal and external. And in our next class, we will be doing the theory of the firm in the form of cost and revenues of the firm, how cost, different types of costs are involved in the production process and how will they be able to calculate it and what is the importance of these costs in order to make a decision about profit maximizing level of output or the shutdown point of the firm. So all these things will be analyzed in our next session of the class. So that's all for today. Be happy and keep it in touch with your online lessons. Thank you.